Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. May the Lord richly bless you, my listeners, wherever you are. Today also is another day. I have a very good message from God to give it to you. Open chia adofo nemeti funina. Sabi me wo asembi ifri nyakopon ho de ma metifo. Enti me os jidie se obi obi ti ni bia ni be ne ebeji sa onyame asembi. Hallelujah. Bebeka safa. Adultery. Wona wawalea ugu awalie empaso. Anasu ugu awalie mufi. I'm going to talk about adultery. It's a sin against God, and it is one of the commandments. That is one of the 10 of the commandments God has given to us. So, for a married man or a married woman, committing such sin is a very big and disgrace to their marriage. Owale ni bia na so bia owale bia wey sad ni bia e de eh fun so kese e na sad ni bua se e ma na de na wale e let us read from the Bible. Exodus chapter 20 verse number 14. You shall not commit adultery. Exodus chapter 20, verse number 14. Bible said, you shall not commit adultery. What is adultery? Adultery is when a married person, whether a woman or a man, going for another man, a woman who has been married, going outside his matrimonial to meet another man or to have sexual intercourse with another man, commit adultery. So also it is for a man who has married, going outside his matrimonial and have intercourse with the woman, also commit adultery. Since this is a command, and it's written in the 10th commandment, if you does this, you are bringing disgrace, you are bringing sickness, you are bringing, you are disobeying God. Let me put it this way, because this is how it is. You are disobeying God. Thou shalt not commit adultery. Now, it's a common thing for people to do this because they think it's fashion. It's not fashion. It's wrong. And it's devilish thing to do as a married couple. But of all, me can't me as a matcher will say, say, we are walling me. They say, why are you say, so you're bema, so you're ba. Now, why are you being say, Udie? Oh, girlfriend, oh, boyfriend, oh, our lady, me catch the old necessary savagin. A year upon summer pine, then your minimum, and shin your minimum. A bit me a moan yale, a bit me the ugua bro, a bit me the guasia bro. Now we a yen sha, when young coupon, emerald send dunimono, what they account, say, When you do this, it's like you're committing a crime against your marriage. Where we are, and he said, why are you born in the world? Why are you born in the world? Oh, well, yeah, well, well. Unto me, for yes, I am patron. Bear my oba, well, well, yeah, oh, no, you don't want. Oba for the preacher, why am I from sure? Emma Fanny, you're the chair, why am I from sure? Na saadi we no e ya di bi a e ye boni kesi pa o nyame ni ene di yale e o ha atete e bre mu mi ru nyina se ba akoko ya na mo se mu mi ru no mo ye ba ko ndi e ma honhun mu ni hunam nyina ro e bre mo se do not commit adultery whether a woman or a man who does such things after their marriage, committing adultery, and is abomination before God. Ubiya wawalea ufa ukunachi bema waba wawalea ufa ukunachi bema wawalea ufa ukunachi no eje aponeke seba etiye sabi beno kasa se unyamia kuwa. Awale ya wawale ni mwoni nji hon. Mwono wa yere mkwa. Ene wose mudisa agro. You can have intercourse with your wife only once you marry. You cannot go after any woman after your marriage. You cannot go after any man after you marry. After your marriage. You have to do sexual intercourse with your wife or with your husband. You two have the right to do this. No one can go outside to choose whether man or woman to have an intercourse. It's a sin and it's an abomination before God. Therefore, committing adultery is a very serious sin and it will lead you to hell. This is one of the commandments. So don't forget, bear it in mind that you have to stay with your wife alone. You have to stay with your husband alone. Do not do such things once you are married. It will never fall to you. Sadi we no ya di bia. Nyame achi wade kese ba. Enti pomoten ne show kontene. Se wona moye. Woni wukun won e beti mechia. Adu sadi. Unti mi mfa wukun achi enkoye sa. Unti mi mfa wire achi enkoye sa. Kubeti makoye o. Pate hun sun sun so ho. Heaven judgment is awaiting for you. Atemu oda no etwa. Sabri be ye. But if you say, I think we'll answer again. Judgment is awaiting for you people who does such things after their marriage, after their matrimonial house. You have your right to obey God. You have your right to disobey God. But I'm telling you, as a Christian, as a human being on this earth, there is no escape. The judgment you will face it, anything you does to give you, you have to give the accounts before God. And for our wale in the abro. Shame who say, when away you go on. And I'm obeying a shim, a disagro. Shame who say, when you come on. And I'm obeying a disagro. Shame who say, won't mean for preaching. Shame who say, won't mean for we let you employ a sardine. The son said, it is against the laws of the Lord. The laws of the Lord. It is against that. And doing that also, you can have a sickness. You can die in that process. Many things can happen to you. And it also sees the presence of the marriage. Praise the Lord. In other words, Mawaninji, Unukum, Serbo Batasi, Na Motimiere, a deep or dog, only a numer deep or dog, said you also would know. Said you also a maratiano. Do not follow other men after your marriage. Do not follow other women after your marriage. You couples have to be faithful to each other. You have to be faithful to each other. And the Lord of God will bless you. And the God who has promised you anything about marriage will provide it for you. You can have a choice to do such things, but I'll tell you now, all creatures are not God. All creatures are not God. Be very careful when you are going to do such things. Remember, it is one of the 10 commandments. Such things can put you in sickness. Such things can bring disgrace to you. Such things can lead you to hell. Adultery is one of the abominations before God. Keep yourself clean. Keep your marriage clean and stay with your wife and stay with your husband. Only two of you, you are one. Once you get married, two become one. You have right to do whatever you want to do. Do not cheat your husband. Do not cheat your wife. Stay together with your wife. Stay together with your husband. Because this adultery is common these days in our society. It is very common for couples, one of them, to do such things. But I want to tell you, time is not our side. And because of judgment awaiting us, whatever you do in your matrimonial house, your matrimonial home, my brother, my sister, there will be an account you have to give to the Most High God. He has the right to judge you. He has the right to question you about this. Be very careful, because committing adultery sees many things in our life, bring sickness in our life, block our blessing in marriage. But if you stay in faithfulness in the marriage, God, who sees you keeping the marriage holy, nice and neat, will provide for you. Because God sees everything you do. Don't forget that there is nothing that can hide before the eyes of the Lord. Adultery is no good for married couples. I repeat it. Be very careful. Stay with your wife. Stay with your husband. Don't ever try this. If you have already committed adultery, ask God for forgiving. And don't ever, ever, ever try this again. Never ever do it again. Ask for forgiveness and God will forgive you. And if you have never do that, don't ever try to do something. It's a devilish plan. It's a devilish way to bring you down, to destroy you, to disgrace you, to break you for entering the promised land. Unyami Unshaw, may the Lord bless you. May the Lord guide you, give you strength to ignore whatever the Spirit lead you to commit sin. Whatever the evil spirit lead you to commit sin, may the Lord Almighty guide you, protect you, give you strength to abolish that out of your marriage, out of your life, and save your life because of heaven. May the Lord bless you. May you be blessed. Amen.